ready? Yene drishyam gatim asau dashamasya isha.
Yene drishyam gatim asau dashamasya isha.
Sangrahita purudayena bhava drishena.
Sangrahita purudayena bhava drishena.
Tenaiva tushyatu kritena sadina nātaha.
Tenaiva tushyatu kritena sadina nātaha.
Onamata prati vignājanin vasya kurya.
Onamata prati vignājanin vasya kurya.
My dear Lord, by your causeless mercy, I am awakened to consciousness. Although I am only 10 months old, for this causeless mercy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the friend of all fallen souls, there's no way to express my gratitude but praying with folded hands. This prayer of the child, Prabhupada says, in the womb may be questioned by some atheistic people. How can a child pray in such a nice way in the womb of his mother? Prabhupada says, everything is possible by the grace of the Lord. The child is put into such a precarious condition externally, but internally he is the same, and the Lord is there. By the transcendental energy of the Lord, everything is possible. Because the Lord is always wanting to bring us back, that's His mercy. He wants to reclaim us, Prabhupada mentions. So therefore, he is always trying to make us remember Him. Just as we forget Him, He is also making Him remember Him. Okay, text 19, you try.
Pashyayam Vishanayanam Saptavadrihi.
Pashyayam Vishanayanam Saptavadrihi.
Sharirakedama Sharirya Parasvadehe.
Sharirakedama Sharirya Parasvadehe.
Yatrishtaya Santamaham Purusham Puranam.
Yatrishtaya Santamaham Purusham Puranam.
Pashye bahir hridi chai yami vapatitam.
Pashye bahir hridi chai yami vapatitam. Translation. A living entity in another type of body sees only by instinct. He knows only the agreeable and disagreeable sense perceptions of that particular body. But I have a body in which I can control my senses and can understand my destination. Therefore, I offer my respectful obeisances to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, by whom I have been blessed with this body and by whose grace I can see Him within and without. Prabhupada gives the evolutionary process of the bodies. He says it's like a flower. How a flower blossoms. So there's a flower in the bud stage, then the blooming stage, the full-fledged stage, and then in the grown-up stage of aroma and beauty. So similarly, there's 8.4 million species of bodies in gradual evolution. And the evolution is the evolution of the consciousness, that's right. It's not that the monkeys become human being, or reptiles become reptile man or woman like that. It's actually consciousness. We get a body according to our consciousness.
Right.
So every living entity in a certain body is only conscious about its own body and the way it feels. It doesn't feel anything more, anything less. So Prabhupada says animals in bodies lower than that of the human being are conscious only as far as their bodily distress and happiness are concerned. They cannot think of more than their bodily necessities of life, eating, sleeping, mating, and defending. And in only the human form of body, one can really understand what God consciousness is. And that too, that too it's by the grace of Krishna. We take it for granted that, oh, I've come to Krishna consciousness, but actually it is Krishna who has brought us all his devotees' blessing. In both cases, it is Krishna. It's either directly or indirectly. Krishna is kind to us, and that's his grace. So it's not easy in this body to understand our position in relationship with Krishna. But the process allows us to understand this thing clearly. Otherwise, if it's easy, means you can find so many people who are going to yoga studios and all. They all should have been either realized or liberated, right? Some people are doing for years. It's not that easy. Yeah? It has to be done in the right way, according to Guru Parampara, and then connected properly. Then we realize through that process. And part of realization is actually developing humility. It's not like, you know, I'm reading, therefore it should happen. Or I'm chanting, therefore it should. No. One has to develop humility at the same time. And understand we are actually in a very precarious situation. Suffering, trying to enjoy senses. And we don't even know that we are suffering. And so, by the mercy of both the devotees and Krishna, we realize that we are suffering. Then that is when realization actually starts. And that's when you do your sadhana bhakti, you can understand better. Sadhana bhakti means you're following strictly what your guru has already taught and what Srila Prabhupada has established. That is sadhana bhakti. It's not something that you can download and then read and then say, I'm following. It's not like that, yeah. Certain material things you can do, but spiritual thing is a whole new ball game. Huh? You can download all the books also. But the change of heart must take place. So you see it, the process starts from first you accept as God, then you read about God, then you associate with the devotees, then you chant, and then you take shelter of a spiritual master. And all that is for what? Trying to relationship with Krishna, trying to connect. Not that you come to, once you initiate it, then that's it, finish. I am pure, Om Tat Sat, you know, right? I am some great being like that. No, it's not like that. It's more than that. It's more important at that time when you initiated to really actually to control one's senses. Then you can get closer to Krishna. Okay. So without the mercy of the Lord, we are not able to understand any of this thing. We are not independent. We are very much dependent on Krishna. The degree of dependency towards Krishna, we don't understand actually. Text 20.
Soham vasannapi vibho bahudukha vasam.
Soham vasannapi vibho bahudukha vasam.
Garbana nirjigami seva hiranda kupe.
Garbana nirjigami seva hiranda kupe.
Therefore, my Lord, although I am living in a terrible condition, I do not wish to depart from my mother's abdomen to fall again into the blind well of materialistic life. Your external energy called Deva Maya at once captures a newly born child and immediately false identification, which is the beginning of the cycle of continual birth and death, begins. So it seems that when you are in the womb and when you are conscious of your situation, at that time Maya is not covering you. It's interesting, but that's how it is. Just to give the living entity an opportunity to consider and to understand. Once you come out, that's it, you know. The consequences are heavy. So the living entity here, understanding that, is praying to Krishna. They say, please don't let me get covered up again. And then you can read Bhaktivinoda Thakur's prayers, song, where he says when he was young, because of all the affections and kissing and all, he completely forgets the misery of the material world. As a little boy, and then he trying to enjoy the material world. But you can see from this particular prayer, when the living entity understands this terrible situation, he is praying not to take birth again.
He's also praying also by the mercy of the people.
The mercy is by the, of course, remembering all those prayers. Yeah.
And this, his intense humility, like he's praying. While in the womb also in so much pain, he can pray.
Yeah. Mercy of the Lord. Yeah, the prayers all, whatever we're doing is coming from the mercy of the Lord. So it's a very dangerous situation, and then he is worried about even the more dangerous situation. But once he comes out, the false ego takes over. So he's praying not to be covered by this false ego. And once again thinking, I am the body, I am the hero, I am the captain. Like that. Then I am the boss, I'm the temple president, I'm the book distributor, all these things, identification, unnecessary. We are actually servants of Krishna. As servant, we can do whatever Krishna wants us to do and should be doing. So the whole world, you see, everyone is just worried about what they are and what they should be doing, enjoying. So Prabhupada talks about Sukadeva Goswami, how he wanted to remain within the womb. Actually, he was there for 16 years. When you read about this, you're wondering why he was in the womb, but he remained for 16 years because he realized if he comes out, the Maya will cover him. So he told Vyasadeva, I'm not coming out. Vyasadeva said, please come out, my son. He said, no. He said, you bring Krishna and then I'll come out. Then when Krishna came, he told Krishna, I'm not coming out. And then Krishna said, please come out. He said, no. Unless you promise me Maya won't affect. Then Krishna said, okay. Then he came out, he grew up and immediately ran to the forest. He wasn't attached to anything. So that's immediately left him. Not a single moment he stayed behind. He didn't want to get entangled in any ashram life. Because later, Vyasadeva, through chanting of the Bhagavatam prayers, he attracted his son to come back and learn from him. And so then he taught him the whole Bhagavatam, which is what we are hearing now. So it's like that. Such a strong situation is material nature. It's text 21.
Tasmadaham vigata viklava uddharisya.
Tasmadaham vigata viklava uddharisya.
Atmanamashrutamasahrudatmanaiva.
Atmanamashrutamasahrudatmanaiva.
Bhuyo yata vyasanametadanekarandram.
Bhuyo yata vyasanametadanekarandram.
Mame bhavishyadupasadita vishnupadah.
Mame bhavishyadupasadita vishnupadah.
Therefore, without being agitated anymore, I shall deliver myself from the darkness of nescience with the help of my friend. Clear consciousness. The friend is a clear consciousness. Simply by keeping the lotus feet of Lord Vishnu in my mind, I shall be saved from entering into the wombs of many mothers for repeated birth and death. The Prabhupada's point is, as long as you are in this material world, it is miserable. You cannot say it's better this home or that home. Every family, every birth you take, there is always misery. It could be less misery in one place or more misery in another, but misery is always there. So we cannot think that there's no material miseries. It's only in Vaikuntha or Goloka there's no more miseries. Otherwise, we are suffering. And as long as we keep taking birth, we will keep continuing to suffer. And therefore, there's no end to this suffering. You cannot say when it's going to end. It's never going to end. As long as you are thinking materially. Prabhupada says it does not end, even if you change this body. So you think, oh, this life is terrible, I'll take another birth. And then you become another family, and then another kind of problem catch you. Your karma will always come with you. So this kind of thinking is not advised. Prabhupada said the best thing is to develop Krishna consciousness. Yeah. Upasadita Vishnupadaha. That means to take shelter of the lotus feet of Krishna. How to take shelter is already given to all of us by Srila Prabhupada. How to practice it is already given by Srila Prabhupada. Why we don't practice it is something we have to ask ourselves. Right? Otherwise, we are like the child in the womb. Every time we are in trouble, we pray, oh Krishna, I will do nicely next time. This time you excuse us. And then after a few days, you forget. Not just one, a few days, just a few days. Not 1 year or 2 years, after a few days. You will see, you can test yourself. Just after a few days, you'll forget how serious you must be. And then you resolve again, yes, I'll be serious. It's like waves. Our intensity grows up, and then after that, goes down again. So like Tarangini, the waves, up and down. So when we follow Prabhupada's instruction, particularly by chanting and reading his books are very important because our intelligence and consciousness is purified by his words. Okay, it's not going to be in any other way. Yeah? You can purify your sinful activities by taking prasadam to some extent, but the best way is to purify your intelligence. So then, purifying intelligence means what? Understanding that you have to do service. You're not just taking initiation and that's it. Go and do some service. Something that connects you with Krishna. So therefore your consciousness gets more purified and you get elevated and you can think things in a Krishna conscious way. And Prabhupada says one should continue to chant Hare Krishna like that so that the cycle of birth and death is completely stop. Okay, next verse.
Kapila uvacha.
Kapila uvacha.
Evam kritam atirgarbhe.
Evam kritam atirgarbhe.
Dasamashyastu van rishihi.
Dasamashyastu van rishihi.
Sadhyakshipat avachinam.
Sadhyakshipat avachinam.
Asutya
Lord Kapila continued, the 10-month-old living entity has these desires even while in the womb. But while he thus extols the Lord, the wind that helps parturition propels him forth with his face turned downward so that he may be born. So he's forced to take birth. Pushed downward all of a sudden by the wind, the child comes out with great trouble. Head downward, breathless and deprived of memory due to severe agony. So the child is pushed through, the Prabhupada says, the narrow passageway. His head is all squeezed and everything, and he can't breathe. and he comes out, and because of that terrible the whole thing, his experience is so devastating, he completely forgets what he was praying before. So this is how birth is taken place. Okay.
Patito bhuvi, patito bhuvi asran misraha,
patito bhuvi asran misraha,
vishta bhuri vacheshtate,
vishta bhuri vacheshtate,
roru yati gati jnane,
roru yati gati jnane,
viparitam gatim gatim gataha,
viparitam gatim gataha.
The child thus falls on the ground, smeared with stool and blood, and placed just like a worm germinated from the stool. He loses his superior knowledge and cries under the spell of Maya. So that's how the child is, right? And the doctor will hit the child, put the finger in the mouth, and pull out whatever mucus, and then the child then cries. So at that moment, he is in the spell of Maya. Text 25.
Parachandam na vidusha.
Parachandam na vidusha.
Ushyamano janena saha,
ushyamano janena saha,
anabhipretam apannaha,
anabhipretam apannaha,
pratyakhyatum anishvaraha,
pratyakhyatum anishvaraha.
After coming out of the abdomen, the child is given to the care of persons who are unable to understand what he wants, and thus he is nursed by such persons. Unable to refuse whatever is given to him, he falls into undesirable circumstances. It's interesting. Yeah, the child can do nothing. So whatever is poison, you know, made to drink, they may inject him when just born, you know, put medicine in the mouth, all kinds of things happen. So that's all they can do. They cry. The only thing that makes them happy is just the milk from the mother. Right? Anyway, they are forced to take everything. Text 26.
Sāyito asuchit paryāṅkhe,
sāyito asuchit paryāṅkhe,
jantus vedaja dūṣite,
jantus vedaja dūṣite,
nāśa kanduyane angānām,
nāśa kanduyane angānām,
āśam nottāna cheṣṭane,
āśam nottāna cheṣṭane.
So Kapila Muni just describes how bad this world is. Laid down on a foul bed, infested with sweat and germs, the poor child is incapable of scratching his body to get relief from his itching sensation, to say nothing of sitting up, standing, or even moving. So, you know, so terrible. Everything is so terrible. 27.
Tudantyama tvacham damsa,
tudantyama tvacham damsa,
mashaka matkunadayaha,
mashaka matkunadayaha,
udantam vigatajnanam,
udantam vigatajnanam,
kramyaha krimikam yata,
kramyaha krimikam yata.
In this helpless condition, gnats, mosquitoes, bugs, and other germs bite the baby, whose skin is tender. Just as smaller worms bite a big worm, the child, deprived of his wisdom, cries bitterly. So here, the whole thing is gone. His knowledge of the spiritual thing which he was praying previously is gone. So now he is identifying with what he is going through. He's crying out. Prabhupada says not only children, because it's easy to forget when they play and do other things. After a while, you train them, and then by the time they're 16, 18 years old, they forget what they did. So it's not only children, but also elderly persons should be very careful to protect their sense of Krishna consciousness and avoid unfavorable circumstances so that they may not forget their prime duty. Right? So when you go visit your family members, they all are not favorable, so they may be doing unfavorable things. So you think, oh, they are family members, and then, but then you are forgetting your Krishna consciousness. Text 28.
Ityevam saishavam bhuktva.
Ityevam saishavam bhuktva.
Dukkam paugandam evacha.
Dukkam paugandam evacha.
alabdhapsito jnya ajnanat
In this way, the child passes through his childhood, suffering different kinds of distress, and attains boyhood. In boyhood also, he suffers pain over desires to get things he can never achieve. And thus, due to ignorance, he becomes angry and sorry. Right? So, you've been through this. As a little kid, they suffer, right? They crawl, they fall down, sometimes they hit their face on the ground, break their teeth, right? And then sometimes children run, fall down, break their hands, or fight in the school, come home, parents have to say, don't worry. So many things. So all this the child goes through. And then as they grow older, they see their friends have iPhone, so they want iPhone, right? PS2, Xbox, all that. If they can't get, they will feel very angry. And then they think, when I grow up, I'll get all this. Right? They think and they imagine they can get all this with money. And they'll think they won't have problems except to buy those two things. This is how material world is. You know? Forced to go through in school means, and the parents will say, you have to pass, get good grades. Right? Go to a good university, become engineer, lawyer, doctor, these are the things. Like that. Yeah. Architect, all kinds of things. So this is how the material life is. And why is he doing that? He's thinking, I will become happy if I do all these things. But actually, where's the happiness? Right? We as adults, we are already going through whatever we wanted to be when we were young. And then we find we are not happy anyway. Right? We dreamt of that, right? And then maybe we didn't get the career we want. And then we may think, oh, if I had got my career, I would be happy. But still, you can see whether the person with the career is happy or another person without a career, we are both unhappy. That's the situation. And yet we are covered because we are thinking our children will be happy. Or we think we will be happy if they get what we didn't get. So this is how the material nature is. It's so powerful. Text 29.
Sahadehena manena.
Sahadehena manena.
Vardhamanena manyuna.
Vardhamanena manyuna.
Karoti vigraham kami.
Karoti vigraham kami.
Kameshvantaya chatmanaha.
Kameshvantaya chatmanaha.
With the growth of the body, the living entity, in order to vanquish his soul, increases his false prestige and anger, and thereby creates enmity towards similarly lusty people. Birds of the feather flock together. So everyone with similar desires will get together. Same, even in your career, in society, gathering, you all have cliques. Everyone, I'm this group, I'm that group, like that. So similarly, even when they are young, they will also get together. And they what they do is they increase their anger and lusty desires. That's all they do, right? Young boys, young girls, what they talk about in school. How to get married, how to do this, how to do that, what job, and then laugh at another person, crack jokes, right? Speak bad about another person. If one guy can speak bad about 10 people, then he's a hero, right? That's how society is. Such a situation in our society. Right. So, Prabhupada quote from Narottam Das Thakur, one of our acharya. He says, Kama Krishna Karmarpane. Due to our lust, we want many things for our sense gratification. So the same lust can be transformed in a purified way, so that we want everything for the satisfaction of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Anger also can be utilized towards a person who is atheistic or who is envious of the Personality of Godhead. As we have fallen into this material existence because of lust and anger, the same two qualities can be utilized for the purpose of advancing in Krishna consciousness, and one can elevate himself again to his former pure spiritual position. So, you know, like Hanuman, he used his anger in the service of Ram. So like that, we can use anger in the service of Krishna. But then it shouldn't be falsely used. We should know how to use it. So we have to be very good in our understanding of the scripture. If two Vaishnavas are fighting, you cannot take sides and show anger to one or not the other. It doesn't work. We should take neutral position. So understanding properly is very important. Otherwise, we don't know how to use our lust or anger correctly. And it will turn into sense gratification. It has to be trained first. Unless we are properly trained by authorities, we don't know how to utilize some of these things. And then we can falsely claim, oh, I need it for my maintenance. You know, I need it for this. I'm one for preaching. We can, and thereby actually money for senses. So that's how our false identity becomes more increased. Text 30.
Bhutai pancha virarabdhe.
Bhutai pancha virarabdhe.
Dehe dehe budosakrat.
Dehe dehe budosakrat.
Aham vamete asagraha.
Aham vamete asagraha.
Karoti kumuta hirmatim.
Karoti kumuta hirmatim.
By such ignorance, the living entity accepts the material body, which is made of five elements, as himself. With this misunderstanding, he accepts non-permanent things as his own and increases his ignorance in the darkest region. Okay. Anyway, we are covered by all these different layers, body and so on, so we identify.
तदर्थं कुरुते कर्म
तदर्थं कुरुते कर्म
यद्वद्धो याति संस्मृतिं
यद्वद्धो याति संस्मृतिं
यो अनुयति तदक्लेशं
यो अनुयति तदक्लेशं
अविद्या कर्म बन्धनः
अविद्या कर्म बन्धनः.
For the sake of the body, which is a source of constant trouble to him and which follows him because he's bound by ties of ignorance and fruitive activities, he performs various actions which cause him to be subjected to repeated birth and death. Unless one is in knowledge, he is always in ignorance. And if you are in ignorance, you are bound to be committing offenses or sinful activities. So various actions in general people do is based on their ignorance. It's not because they clearly understand why they have to do. Their ignorance is based on their sense enjoyment within the material. They don't know the rules within this material world, what a human birth is meant for. So in one sense, you can say they are not at fault. But actually, everyone is supposed to figure out what they are meant to do. And if they are not able to do that, then we have to teach them as devotees and to show them what it is. And therefore, with the ignorance, they think, I have to take care of my body. I have to make sure it is given the pleasures that it is looking for. And therefore, here Kapila Muni is saying, he performs various actions which cause him to be subjected to repeated birth and death. So if they understand that they are going to come back so many times in so many lives and to suffer, if they understand that actually they are suffering, first we have to make them understand their suffering. Then you can say you are taking birth so many times suffering. Then it will make sense for them to think about it. If you can't make them understand that they are suffering, it's not so easy. And if you try to talk to people that they're suffering, they say you are very negative, pessimistic. What kind of group are you all? But actually we are not. We are trying to make people aware that everything is short.
But they feel like they are very happy. Everything is going fine. Job, car, home.
Yeah, but that's just an illusion, right?
Yeah, means they think that it's very hard unless until that point.
So that's why you have to make them understand. Sometimes it's not that you go and tell them immediately, they understand. It may take a while.
Yeah.
Of course, the best way is to give them prasad. So therefore, they think, like you said, I'm doing okay. But then they're only seeing for at that moment. They're not seeing what they went through. They are not seeing what others are going through.
Yeah.
They're not seeing what they will go through in the future. They're not seeing it. Oftentimes, the whole society is only keen on what they need now. If I get my sense enjoyment now, everything is okay. But it's not like that. So Prabhupada says, all these things in society is due to the result of the leaders. And therefore, everyone is sliding down in a hellish condition, birth after birth. And he quotes from the 7th canto, Andaya Tandair Upaniyamanaha. When a blind man leads several other blind men, the result is that all of them fall down in a ditch. So there's a saying, you know, in the land of the blind, the one-eyed man is the king. But then if you know the story, even the guy with the one eye was trying to tell them not to do this, that they said, you're giving us a lot of trouble because you are seeing too many things and therefore you're saying there's so many problems. Then they say, we have a solution. He said, what is the solution? We will make you blind also. So when you try to preach to people, they will think, why are you making me see all these things? They will argue with you. Say, I don't want to see that. And then they say, why are you not being blind? And be like us. So that's exactly what you will find in preaching. But you have to take shelter of Krishna and his holy name and his devotees. And that way we can at least help one or two people. And otherwise, they are all in their bodily concept.
If
therefore the living entity again associates with the path of unrighteousness, influenced by sensually minded people, engaged in the pursuit of sexual enjoyment and the gratification of the palate, he again goes to hell as before. Remember, Prabhupada quoted about Andha Tamishra and Tamishra, hellish condition, where they are then forced to take bodies like dogs and hogs, you know. And they go through so many lifetimes from there, from a dog and a hog, before they take a human birth. So if after going through so much suffering and understanding I shouldn't take birth, and then again associating with such people, that is such a sad situation. So predominantly in society, people are very sensually minded. This Kapila Muni is explaining. And it is true, right? You see everywhere. Basically, what is the main driving force or cultural element in society now, particularly in America? It's basically, you know, sex only, right? I was just reading this morning, they were saying that this football player was fined by the football organization. Because every time he does some, he scores goal, I think, okay? He touches his genitals, okay? So then they say this is not the something a person who is such a highly elevated in society should be doing. So they fined him, you know, $100,000 or something like that. And then he did it again, and so they fined him somehow. So I was thinking, how he's going to not do it again? Because he's associating people who are like that. and their standards are so low, and then they say he has to hold a high standard. So how is it going to happen? Right? If you don't practice it at home or anywhere, how do you expect him not to practice the opening? Right? Whatever he's doing everywhere, he's doing it in the football game also. So it is like that. So they are influenced. Society influences them. So when you send your child into such an environment, they also think that is normal. Who does those kind of activities? Monkeys do those things, right? Apes, huh?
Dogs,
monkeys do those kind of things. Then when human being is doing that, they don't deserve such body. That's what it is. So therefore, Kapila Muni says he again goes to hell as before. Because he doesn't know. Dogs do that. When you see a group of dogs, especially in Vrindavan, they check out each other's, right? They smell the genitals and all. So that's how it is. So we are not like that. We shouldn't be like that. So Prabhupada writes towards the end. When he is in association with saintly persons, all his doubts about the spiritual expansion of life are eradicated. He makes tangible progress on the path of spiritual understanding. So it is not that you meet someone new and you in one day you download all the Bhagavatam in the guy's brain. The guy will probably die or he will curse you. Right? You don't do that. You just show how caring you are or affectionate or loving to them. Then they will be curious. Why are you like that? Then you see, you come and visit us in the temple. Let them experience something. Right? But don't ever force them. Our preachers are so expert, they want to do brain surgery the first day. You can't do that. People get scared of us, you know, they think we are crazy. Yeah, so then you know, all the shlokas come out. The guy's like, "What are you talking in some weird language?" No, actually, people want, like I said before, they want to be loved and appreciated. So if you can show that, then they will think, "What kind of people are you who are showing me love and affection when my own parents and friends didn't show all my life?" And then that is the way we attract people. That is Vaishnavism, actually, because we are compassionate. We want the best for people like that. We have to practice those. That is why I said within the circle of devotees, if you don't show compassion and affection, you cannot show it to outside people. Not possible at all. Impossible. Actually. And therefore, you have to go through difficulties. Just like this, a living entity. So Prabhupada writes, it is also sometimes found that people are very much addicted to a particular type of religious faith. Hindus, Muslims, and Christians are faithful in their particular type of religion. And they go to the church, temple, or mosque. But unfortunately, they cannot give up the association of persons who are too much addicted to sex life and satisfaction of the palate. Here it is clearly said that one may officially be a very religious man, but if he associates with such persons, then he is sure to slide down to the darkest region of life. So it happens. You may be religious, then you work for some boss who is a really low class guy. And then he says, "I want you to come for the end of the year party to some restaurant." And then you say, "No, it's okay." Then you say, "You don't come, I'll make sure you have a good year next year." So then you go. Everybody is drinking and they say, "Why you're not drinking?" Then you say, "No, I'll tell the oranges or what." But nowadays they don't care. They mix and spike your drinks. And then you will get drunk one day because you are associating. Then you'll think, "Oh, it's okay. It's nothing wrong. You know, actually, it's not so bad. I didn't feel so terrible." And then you also say, "Yeah, we'll drink." You know? I've seen it, like a lot of Indian boys. In the 80s when they came to US, you talk to them, they'll say, "I'm from Brahmin family." Ask them, "What are you all doing?" "I'm in college studying." You know? So, but we are working also to pay off. "And where are you working?" "McDonald's, you know, hamburger joints." So how you can do all these things? Because they think paying the Bill says, okay, as long as you work in this environment. And so another group also like that. They say, oh, I'm vegetarian, but I work in a McDonald's or Burger King like that. I won't eat or anything, but I'm working. But what is this knowledge? Right? How many people are responsible for that killing of that? Yeah. So all this, unless you know this knowledge, you'll think it's okay. That there's no what the sin like that. So no matter how religious you may be, if you associate with wrong people and then you think they are your well-wishers, that's it. They really wish you well in the well. It becomes devoid of truthfulness, cleanliness, mercy, gravity, spiritual intelligence, shyness, austerity, fame, forgiveness, control of the mind, control of the senses, fortune, and all such opportunities. All the good things are gone if you have bad association and if you're addicted to all this sense gratification. It'll go away. To get some sense gratification, particularly, you know, the drug addicts, they're all good people. Originally, they were all good people, right? They get a taste of drugs and then they become addicted and they become thieves. They speak bad lies to steal. All truthfulness gone. And they're not clean. They'll be drinking in some dirty place with a shot in the hand. And then they think they're enjoying an illusion. So all these are going. Truthfulness, cleanliness, mercy. All these are the four principles. Very important things too. Austerity, mercy, cleanliness, truthfulness. These are very high principles that if you give up, then you're no more a human being. So these things we have to protect them very clearly. Particularly in Kali Yuga, truthfulness, you have to somehow protect it. Right? When you do something wrong and someone asks you, then you lie, then you can understand you are not upholding dharma. And then you've lost that the fourth leg also. You are nobody, actually. Somehow or other, you have to maintain it. Yeah, so maybe if you speak the truth, you will look like a fool. But better you speak the truth and look like a fool than not speaking the truth and going to hell. You know? Right? So we have to become very, very cautious about our dealings, who we deal with, how to deal with these people. So you see, cleanliness, mercy, shyness. Now these women don't have shyness anymore, you know. In those days, even 50 years ago, people were very reluctant, you know. Now they don't care. And they don't want these things. The leaders of society all over, they don't want all these things. They want all this equality. Prabhupada says they want so they can have unlimited sex enjoyment. That's why they don't want women to be shy and so on. So you see, and who they promote? All the Bollywood actors and Hollywood actors and what are the? Collywood?
Tollywood. All
nuts. So then they put them up in the pedestal. And these people have no culture. They are all like animals. The only difference is they wear a little bit of clothes, you know. And even then, they don't wear half the time. And this is the role model for the younger generation. So who are our role models in society? These are all the movie stars and the sports people. And none of them have any good education or culture. Maybe one or two may have culture. But then that's only material culture. But material culture is not the same as having spiritual culture. Spiritual culture makes a person a gentleman and a lady. Right? Without spiritual culture, then you cannot have a person as a gentleman or a lady. They are all just something. Cultureless. That's why Prabhupada is, you know, wanting us not to be like living like cats and dogs.
Gravity.
grace, to be grace. So therefore, you can see when the sages of Nandasharanya forest, led by Shonagar Rishi, when they are talking to Sukha Goswami, they, what did they say about people in Kali Yuga? All and of one, you know, in this iron age of Kali, men have all but short limbs.
They are
very unfortunate because they are always unqualified, lazy, misguided, and always disturbed. Always disturbed. And because they don't have the right people to guide them. Text 34. One should not associate with a coarse fool who is bereft of the knowledge of self-realization, and who's no more than a dancing dog in the hands of a woman. Pretty much a lot of the, you know, leaders or role models are like this. You know, the men are not really real men. In fact, now you don't know who is men. Right? It's true, no? And you don't know. It's true, right? You can't really tell. They may be all big body, all, but then they say, I am gay or whatever they talk. So you don't know who is man anymore. It's a sad situation. Therefore, it's so important to protect our children. Because this is what you are going to let them associate with. The culture is terrible out there. Causeful and doesn't understand anything about religious ideologies. Okay, that is what a causeful is. He doesn't know what the goal of life is. Doesn't want to know. So what is the difference between an animal and one who don't want to know about the goal of life? This is what Prabhupada keeps mentioning. You don't want to be like cats and dogs. What is cats and dog means? What do cats and dog do? Eating, sleeping, eating, but have you seen what they do? They just go from one partner to another partner. That's all. That's their life. Out there. And then they'll bark. The dog will say, why are you coming to my territory? That's what we are doing. Oh, Krishna. You know? When we start becoming serious in Krishna consciousness, then we value truthfulness. Right? We want all the devotees to be truthful also. Then we become clean. Because Krishna is there when it is clean. Cleanliness next to godliness. The mercy also. We feel sorry for someone. So we extend that our mercy, or we extend our love. What else we extend?
Support.
Compassion to others. We want them to have a better life like us. We feel this will help them. Intelligence. We share with them what can help them in their life. And then we give up all the unnecessary things in our life, right? Most devotees have given up something. Then cut down on material opulence, not interested in fame, able to forgive, and controlling the mind and the senses. If you can control the mind and senses, you can do many of these things as you progress in your Krishna consciousness. Otherwise, you know, it becomes very difficult. So when you are a new devotee, you should be careful in your life. You meet people who are very much attached to women or to men. Men attached to men, women attached to women, or whatever attachment they have. You have to be very careful. Once you know that, you just like, hey, nice, and then like that. but cannot get too intimate with these people. Because they are unclean, the consciousness is unclean, and then it can affect your Krishna consciousness. They may be nice people, but you cannot associate with them. That's the difference. You can give your association, but not take their association. They'll be so nice and say, let's go to the bar and drink, you know. And you say, no, just come with me, you know, be my, keep me company at least. And then you go, they'll take you to a gay club or whatever, then you don't know what to do. Isn't it? What are you going to do? It is difficult. But now they're making it as a mainstream. Right? The legal means they're making it mainstream. Everywhere, right? How many percentage of people are like that? Very few people. But they're making it into like it's a norm. There is nothing wrong with this thing.
And if five states are there too, they are fine.
No, it'll all change, don't worry. They're all nonsense. The leaders are nonsense. How long are they going to hold up? You know, you want to say all this shouldn't be done, but yet they're doing all other nonsense. So therefore, they cannot sustain. They are not truthful. So you cannot sustain. You must have principles to sustain people. You don't want to protect your children. And the same thing like gun control also, right? They're not interested in making sure people can't access guns. But they say, oh, it's a freedom. It's a right. And then everyone gets shot in the school, in the hospital, everywhere. So I don't know whether when you work in Microsoft, they have what they have, that metal detectors. How you know one day some guy comes and shoots and then they'll start putting it up? So maybe you should write and say, yes, we need metal detectors. But then everyone is bringing some gadgets. Such is life. How can you say it's a great life? Right? Now you'll see all the hospital will have metal detectors or some security, and then you have to go through standing like that, like I quote. It's such a silly thing. It is necessary. It is so silly, but it's necessary.
Instead of doing all this, they can just ban guns.
Yeah, but this requires an entire cultural change, a cultural revolution. They will say they are all Kshatriyas.
Well, they not make money. They still
Main income is from the income. Thank you.
So you are saying that they pass these rumors that they want to stop guns. People are more scared and they buy more guns.
Well, that's what happened.
That's the main. They want to make more money.
Yeah, that's what happened in one state where they said they're going to ban all the guns. So the gun sales went up 300%.
Okay.
Then these are all, you know, lack of real proper understanding what is good. You can see so many countries don't have gun. You know, like in England and all, you have to have a license to carry. And they don't have that bad a crime rate. Or you take from where I come from, it's Singapore, right? You cannot have gun. If you have gun, if the police catch you, you go to prison. In those days, it used to be death penalty if they find guns or any weapon in your house. Even the bullet you can't have in your house. That's how strict they were. And they didn't have crimes like that.
Singapore, actually, I heard it's a very good country.
Yeah, they are very strict rules.
Actually, everything, like London has, and
crime
rate.
No chewing gum.
No chewing gum. Yeah, because people eat and put under the table and in the movie theaters. So people go everywhere chewing gum stuff. Because they are very bad in cleanliness, the people. So therefore, you have laws for cleanliness.
No,
this is Kali Yuga.
No durian in the trains or
right.
You know the durian.
Yes, the fruit that stinks. Yeah.
Yeah, it stinks like anything. Mm-hmm. They made a move. No durian in the transportation, like trains or buses.
Buses
or,
and so on.
Somebody stick a chewing gum on the train door, automatic door, and the door won't lock. That made a lock.
No, no, very easy. When I was young, they already made chewing gum. No, no. That means the person don't know. I grew up dying. Very young we were.
He was a great and we go and bring us to this day. We couldn't find it, he just caught something that we couldn't double find it. Said, why? Because I only took the cigarette, he put one more side.
Anyway.
That's a joke, I think.
Infatuation and bondage which accrue to a man from attachment to any other object is not as complete as that resulting from attachment to a woman or to the fellowship of men who are fond of women. So this is very important, eh? Because this is very strongly binds people. So we have to be very careful. So nowadays we can change slightly also. Man from attachment to a woman or man or to the fellowship of women, men who are fond of men, women.
Or either.
It's true, because this becomes very, once it contaminates your consciousness, it's very hard to give up. Very difficult. It's harder. It's as strong as being addicted to heroin. In fact, I had a devotee from Italy. I was speaking to him. He said he was addicted to heroin. So he used to take it. Then when the devotees preached to him, he gave it up. Then during the conversation, he was saying, Prabhu, it's better than the woman, the heroin addiction. He said, it's so addictive. Of course, everyone has different levels of tolerance and so on. But this is from Kapila Muni. He's saying the result, attachment to this is the strongest. It's not as complete. That means it's very strong.
Okay. Ajamil story.
Yeah, Ajamil. Ajamil is also funny. He
was attached to the prostitute.
Yeah, he saw and he got attached to the prostitute. But he was already married. So the attachment to that kind of life contaminated his consciousness so strongly. All right. So Prabhupada writes towards the end, in other words, attraction for a woman's or man's association is the cause of the material conditional life, and anyone interested in being freed from this conditional life must detach himself or herself from the association of men or women. Because now there is so much mixing. Right? Because in those days, men were more free to do what they want. And so they are going and doing all the nonsense. Now the society is, they want to be equal, right? Okay, text 36.
Rajapati swam duhitaram.
Rajapati swam duhitaram.
Rishtvata drupa darshitaha.
Rishtvata drupa darshitaha.
Rohit bhutam swam vadhavat.
Rohit bhutam swam vadhavat.
Raksharupi.
Riksha.
Rikshya tatrapaha.
Rikshya.
At the sight of his own daughter, Brahma was bewildered by her charms and shamelessly ran up to her in the form of a stag when she took the form of a hind. So there is this also that great personalities are also bewildered in such situations. So we have to be very careful what to speak of us, no? Such great personalities also captive. Then Prabhupada says, even Lord Shiva, who's never disturbed, was bewildered by a Mohini Murti. Even when Parvati approached him, right, when she was trying to pray to conceive a child from him, he wasn't disturbed. But when he saw Mohini Murti, he was totally captivated. So the whole idea is not to freely mix, but our society wants that to be the main thing, freely mix. Why? Then it can generate economy. Money, unwanted children, all this means more money, more problems in society. The more problem you have, the more you can create solution or tax people. We have this problem, we need more money, we tax you like that. That's the whole idea. They don't want to fix anything. Right? Why would they want to fix? If they can cure a disease, they will not probably release that medicine. Because then they can't generate money for the next few years. So the best thing is to be attracted to Krishna instead of being attracted to all this simply by attracted to Krishna, you will not be attracted to material things. Earlier on, remember, we were reading how Prabhupada said, if one is agitated by sex desires, one should meditate on the eyebrows of the Lord. Particularly, I heard this Balaram.
Text 37.
Amongst all kinds of living entities begotten by Brahma, namely men, demigods and animals, none but the sage Narayana is immune to the attraction of Maya in the form of woman. So everyone who's created is attracted to the form of woman. So no one can say no. Even women are attracted to women. The billboards you see or movie stars, what the woman look at? Oh, she's more pretty than I am. Like that. they are. You can say no, but it is a fact.
Sage Narayana, is it the Lord Narayana?
Narayana.
Narayana.
So everyone, from the highest living entity down to Indra Gopa, they are all attracted to sex life. That is the basic principle. The whole the whole creation is started from the impregnation by in the glands, Lord Shiva, Shambhu into the yoni of the Maya, like that. So therefore, the whole thing is started in sexual attraction. So therefore, they are conditioned in the shackles of sex desire. Text 38.
Balam me pasya maya yaha.
Balam me pasya maya yaha.
Sri maya jaino disham.
Sri maya jaino disham.
Ya karoti padakrantan.
Ya karoti padakrantan.
Bhuvi jhambena kevalam.
Bhuvi jhambena kevalam.
Just try to understand the mighty strength of my Maya in the shape of woman, who by the mere movement of her eyebrows can keep even the greatest conquerors of the world under her grip. Prabhupada immediately talks about Cleopatra. Cleopatra, and who was the one? Who was the... No. Not Napoleon. Who was the
Roman?
Caesar. That's Mark Antony. Right? Mark Antony and Caesar. So they were attracted to her. And it is said that the big war that was started in those times, she had the face that launched 1,000 ships, right, in Shakespeare. So to win her, they had a big battle. Is it Cleopatra or another Greek maiden? Supposed to, they were so attracted. Maybe it was Aphrodite or something. Something like that. I can't remember. But so they had a big war within. The king wanted to marry her. So 1,000 ships were sent to fight because of that beauty. So just imagine what is one or two people in the hands. And this is also true. If you had been in college years and so on, and I have been, and I know when my friends got involved with the girl, that was it. You can't see them. You can't even call them, they won't answer. They are under the control of the their girlfriend. They are more important than all then suddenly you are no more the best friend. The girl has become the best friend. And then after 6 months it will be another girl. So that's amazing. Even Kapila Dev is saying it's so powerful. And
why
so this
why they always say attraction of women instead of the men, both ways, right? Why scriptures always say like, you know?
Because Maya is feminine. And she is very alluring in this material. So that most attractive form is a feminine form. Whatever you attract in the material nature is actually feminine. And therefore both, whether you take a body of a man or a woman, you're still attracted to the feminine body. We are attracted to material nature. We want to enjoy material nature. The proper rights also, you asked in the proper rights, the captivating power of woman and man's susceptibility to such attraction must also exist in the Supreme Personality of God in the spiritual world and must be represented in the transcendental pastimes of the Lord. Yeah, because he's always been messed around by Radharani. So it's there in the spiritual world also. So he's only attracted by his own energy. And that's Radharani. But then in the case of Haridas Thakur, he shows us how when you are fixed in Krishna consciousness, even Maya, who is so powerful, could not disturb his focus. Right? Instead, he initiated her. Gave her the ability to chant. So Prabhupada writes towards the end of that paragraph, the tendency to be attracted by womanly beauty is natural because it exists in the spiritual world. In the material world, it is reflected pervertedly, and therefore there are so many problems or inebrieties. So how do you get over this conundrum, right? You take up deity worship. By touching the deity's form, by bathing, by looking at the deity, your attraction for the material body and the attraction for sexual desire will go away. So it should be, you know, you should try to do a lot of that deity worship. And by bathing the deities and dressing them, you'll get a lot of attraction for that. That is a higher attraction than other things. And you find every day you'll be thinking, when I'm going to dress like that. So you don't think of material things anymore. Like that. So when you're attracted to the forms of Radha and Krishna, Prabhupada says, you're no longer attracted by the material feminine beauty. Then when you look at a beautiful girl, you won't be attracted. You still think, my Radha and Krishna are most beautiful. Right? There's a pastime in Ramanujacharya. He had this one man was carrying his umbrella for this girl.
He's the man. Yes. You know the drama.
Oh, okay. So attracted.
Danuja.
Danuja.
I think he was the girl.
And then finally, when Ramanujacharya told him, "You come, I'll show you the most beautiful thing," and he shows Ranganath's eyes. Then he wasn't attracted still. Then Ramanuja prays to Ranganath, let him see your beauty. Then when he saw, that was it. Both of them, the girl and them, they both became pure devotees. So once you get attracted, you know material attraction. So that is what we should all aspire for. We should always see Radha Neela Madhava, Narasingha Deva, all in Gaurnita as the most beautiful thing in the world.
ప్రతిలబ్ధమాత్మలాభో
Krishna aspires to reach the culmination of yoga and has realized his self by rendering service unto me, should never associate with an attractive woman. For such a woman is declared in the scripture to be the gateway to hell for the advancing devotee. There'll be a problem. If you have a very beautiful wife, every man will be looking at her. Particularly in Kali Yuga, it's terrible. You see that. When you go to airport, you watch, right? That's where you study people and you understand how this material world are evolving. Sex desire is very strong. You can study people. So you just sit and watch. If any beautiful woman go, all the, even the workers, every guy will stop and look. And then if she's someone's wife, then how is it, right? Everyone in the mind is either having sex with her or raping her or whatever. So this is the bad situation in Kali Yuga. And so, therefore, here Kapila Muni is explaining why it's not good to associate with the attractive. Similarly, in the Pandavas also, right, Draupadi is supposed to be so beautiful, very beautiful. She's so attractive that so many kings want to marry her, but they couldn't. When Arjuna and the Pandavas got it, they were very envious, you know, caused so much problem. So you can also say because of her, the whole war started. Actually, Krishna used her to do all this also.
She's also called Krishna, right?
Yes. Well, because she's dark. Krishna means, the long A means light Krishna or darkish. And then Arjuna is also called Krishna because he's also darkish. And he's also attractive at the same time. Anyway, yoginam abhisarvesham madhvatevanta atma shadavan bhajiteyama samayutatma matraha. So, of all, the culmination of yoga is the best. The best yoga is one who always is thinking of me, meditating on me like that. This is the topmost yoga. Actually, everyone should be very careful with association. If not, you'll find there's a lot of problems. Even Chanaka Pandit says, right? He says, if you have a beautiful wife, that is your biggest problem. He says it in a different way. I just can't remember. You remember? He says it like it's the greatest. It's like three things he says are something that is bad for a man. One is a beautiful woman, one is an unqualified son, and then one more thing he says. And I always think this is amazing, Chanakamadi, the way he says. So one has to be very careful with how one is, especially in modern society. Everything is so open, huh? Women want freedom and so on. But actually, the men who claim that they need freedom are the ones who want to exploit them. And just for sense of just nothing. It's low class. Low class. Prabhupada is low class. Text 40.
Yopayati sanirmaya.
Yopayati sanirmaya.
Yoshideva vinirmika.
Yoshideva vinirmika.
Tam ikshetatmano mrutyum.
Tam ikshetatmano mrutyum.
Trinai kupam ivavrutam.
Trinai kupam ivavrutam.
The woman created by the Lord is the representation of Maya, and one who associates with such Maya by accepting services must certainly know that this is the way of death, just like a blind well covered with grass. Now this is talking about when there's no culture involved. That means you're just not following any rules and regulations. It doesn't refer to the Vaishnava devotees and like that. You know? So you shouldn't read it like that and say all women are Maya.
Yeah, because Gurusta is also ashram, right?
Yes. So it's exactly. So it has to be properly understood when Kapila is saying like this. You know, if you don't, if anything has a utility, you know, so if it's not used properly, then it's going to cause some problem. So same way, a woman has a role to play. And so if people don't see a woman's role properly, then it becomes Maya. It doesn't just woman, anything, it becomes Maya. It's like computer, you don't use it properly, and use for nonsense, it's Maya, like that. I remember when I first came to the movement, every time they will say woman is Maya, and I'm like, what? I have three sisters, my mother, they're all Maya. They are the ones who made me become devotees, they are Maya. So people don't understand properly, they talk like that. It is wrong. You shouldn't talk like that. You know? It doesn't describe a devotee. It is talking about ordinary association. And devotee women should be also careful. Because we have seen so many cases where sannyasis fall down with women and so on. So therefore, it is important also. It's not only the responsibility of men. Devotee women also should become responsible and to protect their chastity also. So Prabhupada talks about how this restriction, 50 years ago in Hindu society, such association was restricted. Means a man easily can't talk. A woman could not see her husband during the daytime. During Prabhupada's time, they can't see during the daytime. So they had another place, like even the king's, the queen's palaces, nobody can go. Only the king can go after he's finished his daytime job. A wife could not see her husband during the daytime. So even householders even had different residential quarters, internal quarters, residential. So you know, different those days. Now they have houses that is only, what, 20 by 10. And everything, two families living in that. So therefore there's no restriction, nothing. Everyone is living like animals. Then there's another thing. Acceptance of service rendered by a woman may appear very pleasing, but one should be very cautious in accepting such service because it is clearly said the woman is a gateway to death of forgetfulness of oneself. She blocks the path to spiritual. Again, this is outside thing, not referring to devotees. But I've seen it also in my own life. I've seen where a devotee, he was thinking he was very advanced. So he was living in this temple. And then this woman came to divorce. She came to do the service. So then, because she's so expert in doing it, he started engaging her. He is a brahmachari. And then he was living upstairs, and then she didn't go home and she stayed downstairs like that after a while. And she didn't want to go home because fight with her husband or something. So then this continued, you know. And after a while, she was doing some of the services for the deities also, even though she wasn't initiated yet. So he was letting her do, and he's like, I'm in charge, I'll do. You just make this, prepare this, then that. Slowly, slowly. Then one day, he fell down with her. And then he started quoting scripture that she is Maya, this is that, and so on. He's the one rascal. He did it and he blamed her. At first he said he was wrong. He made a mistake. After 1 week, he started quoting Sashra saying, she is Maya, she made me do this. And then finally he left the movement. He became Ritvik. But point is, still, association must be restricted. You shouldn't just freely do it and thinking it's okay. Text 41.
Yam manyate patim mohan.
Yam manyate patim mohan.
Manmayam vrishabhayitam.
Manmayam vrishabhayitam.
Strithvam stri sangatah prapto.
Strithvam stri sangatah prapto.
Mittapatya grihapradam.
A living entity who, as a result of the attachment to a woman in his previous life, has been endowed with the form of a woman, foolishly looks upon Maya in the form of a man, her husband, as the bestower of wealth, progeny, house, and other material assets. So now your question is answered. So there was this story also that I heard, that two devotees, I think maybe it's by Bhakti Siddhanta Saraji, that they were coming to walking together, two brahmacharis, they walk. And then they saw in a river one girl was drowning, and then she was asking for help. So these two brahmacharis looked at each other, and then one of them quickly ran, carried the woman, girl out, and then put her out and saved her life. And then once the people came, everyone said, oh, you did a good job. And then they were walking back. So they continued walking. So they were talking, and then they were walking. And then after like few hours later, when before they were reaching their village, the guy who didn't save turned and said, how can you do that? This is, I cannot understand how you can touch the girl. You are a brahmachari. And then the other guy turned and said, you know, I only touched her once when I saved her. You've been touching her all the way from that mm-hmm. place for the last 2 hours. Yeah. So it's how our consciousness should be. Yeah. So these are very important things. Attachment is very important. So if you are completely thinking all the time like that, then obviously in the next life you will become a woman. A man, and a man will become a woman. A woman will become a man if she is too attached to thinking of the husband at the time of death. So Prabhupada says a woman's attachment may elevate her to the body of a man in the next life, but a man's attachment to a woman will degrade him. Yeah. It's okay for a woman to be attached to the man, yeah? Because it's said that it's easy to practice spiritual life in a man's body, comparatively. But then Prabhupada also says a woman can have, is much softer, and she can pray with a loving feeling, so the man cannot, is it too harsh? But in the terms of controlling and so on, it's easier when you are a man. That's what it is. He can give up family and go. Whereas a woman, when their whole consciousness is economy, you know, they have to make sure everything is set up. Have you bought the vegetables? Have you done this? Have you done that? Like that. That is the way they see things. Everything, the house is set up properly, economy, like that. Where the man, oh, if there's no bread, that's okay, don't eat, like that. Right? my woman, no bread, no, go and buy, I have to do this. Where's the chapati?
Right now.
Huh?
Right now.
Right now, exactly.
Then they say you go and buy.
So that's the conscious difference, actually. One is more economy of the nature, like that. That's the only reason why it's difficult for a woman. They become very attached to the situation. But in any case, we have to
understand. They want to take care of children.
They think like that, but it's actually attachment to that situation. They want everything to be stable. Oh, this is moved slightly, they move. Yeah.
But what's true?
Yeah. If the cup is not in the right place, it'll move, and then okay.
Somebody moves my cup.
Yeah. Why everything not there? So it's more attached to that situation at that moment in their life. Whereas a man won't care, so it's easy for him to give up and take up spiritual life. That's the difference. Ideally, that's the difference. The way I see it also. You know, no point arguing who's better. But this is the subtleties they have. I mean, it's just like you can't compare a Volkswagen to a Mercedes Benz. It's both are cars, but one is different from another. So the same thing, men are different, women. That's why they say men are from Mars, women is from Venus. There are differences, and we have to accept that. No matter, there's no such thing as equality. It's a false thing, it's a nonsense thing. Yeah, so basically we're all suffering either in a man or a woman's body. So Prabhupada writes here, so a woman is generally fond of household prosperity, ornaments, furniture, dresses. So it's a fact. You know, Prabhupada don't write this because he has nothing else better to do. And a man, the house, if the woman is not there, it'll be a pigsty. Right? Right? It's a mess. It'll be a mess. Let's say you go to India for 3 months, you come back, it's a whole thing. And he'll say, I was waiting for you. Oh.
I'm missing you.
Yeah, I'm missing you. I was waiting. I was going to clean actually.
one hour before.
Yeah, 1 hour before. Try something.
3 days is too much. 3 months is too much.
Yeah, 1 week already too much. That's a fact, because you see that very few men will, because they have no attachment actually. They are really.
But that's better, probably. That's good that they renounce everything.
Yeah, in a sense, for spiritual life, it is good. So that's what you see. Yeah, but you know, yeah, that's a different matter. The thing is, they are renounced in one sense. Yeah. They can live in a terrible place.
But home is also temple, right? Yeah.
Yes.
So
I agree with you. I'm not saying no. I'm just saying that's how the nature is. Yeah. Because they think, oh, life will do that. There's a renounce like that. Already renounced. Yeah. No, you can do the work but not attach to the results. They are both, no, I renounce the work and the results.
I agree, bro. Yesterday, Lakshmi was saying, I need to set up the house properly. I said, what is there to set up? I said, we said a lot of things are broken and then we need to set all.
In 3 weeks, everything got broken.
But you both are out.
Yeah.
Oh, come on.
That's how it is, I'm telling you. Thanks, 42.
I was thinking I won't attend after lunch because I have to clean the house.
Right.
Tamatmano vijaniya.
Tamatmano vijaniya.
Patya patya grahatmakam.
Patya patya grahatmakam.
Daivopasaditam
rutyam. Daivopasaditam
rutyam. Mrigayorgayanam yata.
Mrigayorgayanam yata. A woman, therefore, should consider her husband, her house, and her children to be the arrangement of the external energy of the Lord for her death, just as the sweet singing of the hunter is death for the deer. Heavy statement. Because when the hunter goes to kill a deer, the way they attack the deer is flute. You play the flute, the deer is like stunned. That is its weakness, the hearing. The hearing for the deer is the weakness. For the fish is the tongue. It likes to taste, so the hook kills it, you know, like that. So different species. For the elephant, it's the sex desire. So they dig a pit and they put the female elephant on the other side and the elephant will fall inside. So they're all traps. So the hunter, so similarly the woman, according to Kapila, they should understand whatever she wants to have nice in the house is actually leading her to
death.
Death, yeah.
So then as devotee woman, we should not keep it clean for her.
No, you have to see Krishna in it. The whole thing, you're doing it for the Krishna conscious reason, not because you want a house. You remember I was saying when Madhiji wanted, they had a nice house, and when their neighbor bought a big house, then she told us, no, I want a bigger house. The whole thing is not Krishna conscious. She wasn't thinking, I have enough, I should be enough to preach. No. So use it for preaching purposes and things like that. Like, you know, like what you are doing today. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, this whole thing is like a gateway to hell, Prabhupada says. So Prabhupada says, all this instruction, Prabhupada says, as Kapila Dev is explaining, that not only is woman the gateway to hell for man, but man is also the gateway to hell for woman. It's a question of who's attached, for what reason they're attached. Okay? If a woman is attached to her husband for his Krishna consciousness, then it's very nice. Then she is freed already. Yeah. And similarly, if the woman is very Krishna conscious, the husband should be attached to her for her Krishna conscious service, but not for their other things. Yeah. So you saw the life of Devahuti. Kadama Muni just let her serve and didn't care. But he was attracted to her in a sense because of her service, not her beauty. He wasn't interested in her. She was a princess, very beautiful princess, very qualified. And then also you can understand she's so qualified because she was willing to do the austerities just to please her husband. And then she had the right to claim a son from him. So Prabhupada says, if the attachment is transferred to Krishna, both of them, man and woman, become Krishna conscious, and then marriage is very nice. So there we know this verse, Anashaktasya Vishayam Yataham Upanyunjata Nirbandha Krishna Sambandhe Yuktam Vairagyam Uchyate. So that's how we try to connect. No matter what we do, our family, our house, our children, everyone should be connected to Krishna. You do your best. If the children, after they turn 16, 17, and then they fight with you and they don't want to be Krishna conscious, then it's not your fault. But make sure that they have a good experience in Krishna consciousness. Then they cannot turn around and say, it was a horrible experience. The Prabhu was always shouting at me. The Mataji was pinching me like that when I was in the temple. So if they have that kind of... right? They think like that, they don't want to go to temple. But if you give such a nice exposure, they'll always have good feelings. Because I remember even in Houston temple, we meet devotees, children, right, who've grown up, married, and they moved to another state. Then they come to visit us after many years. Then they say, I always remember it's so nice to come to the temple. That's why they're coming, stay, you know, like that. So for your own children, they have to be happy. And if they are unhappy, you find out what is making them unhappy. They will say this thing or that thing. Then you try to fix those things. That's for you.
Dehena jiva bhutena.
Due to his particular type of body, the materialistic living entity wanders from one planet to another, following fruitive activities. In this way, he involves himself in fruitive activities and enjoys the result incessantly. Right? Karanam guna sangasya sarasa yomsi janvasya. According to his desire to enjoy a particular modes, he will take that type of body. So either he is going to upper planetary system or lower planetary system. Every planet he is trying to enjoy some level of fruitive activity. Right? Brahmanda Brahmade Konya Bhagavan Jiva Guru Krishna Prasadi Paya Bhakti Lata Beach. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also tells Sanatana Goswami, his living entity is always wandering up and down. But by some good fortune, if he meets a spiritual master, by the mercy of Krishna, they will guide him to Krishna. Like that. First, Krishna shows his grace. If we are very nice people, then he will ask a devotee to meet us. He cannot force us to take Krishna consciousness. When we take up the process, then we meet a guru who will take us back to Krishna. Like that. Yeah, so we have in the Hare Krishna movement, we have this ability to see a bona fide guru and devotees. And so we don't have to go so far. We don't even have to go to India to only meet a sadhu. Now we have it in any country we want. So that is our good fortune, as well as our charity, you can say, to the whole world. Prabhupada's mercy, actually. And he has set up centers everywhere that we can share this mercy of Krishna or Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So they can come and associate. If they ask who's a bona fide spirit, you say, wait a few days, you'll see one. Right? They come and go. Yeah. Otherwise, it's a very difficult situation. Text
44.
This way, the living entity gets a suitable body with a material mind and senses according to his fruitive activities. And the reaction of his particular activity comes to an end. That end is called death. And when a particular type of reaction begins, that beginning is called birth. So this always happens. It's a cycle. It's a cycle. Birth, death, old age, disease. Birth, death, old age, disease. Birth, death, old age, disease. You cannot stop it. The only way is to get out of this thing. So it's just a cycle. And it's just flavored differently. It's like you make dal, sometimes you add dal with chili, sometimes you add with more coriander powder, sometimes you put garam masala in it, sometimes you put some other vegetable. So it's the same dal, but you mix it differently. The same thing, the material life is the same. Puna puna chalpana. Same thing you've experienced. You're not satisfied in this, right? In this life also, you are not satisfied in certain things. Then you're thinking always, I wish I was born like that. I wish. Yam yam va bismaram atyajite ante kalyam. So then you die and then you come. Okay, Krishna says, all right, I'll give you that situation. Plus other things. And then again, then you say, oh, this is not it. I was saying the other day, some people, they are born very short, then they think, I wish I was tall. So all their life they are dreaming, I wish. To. The next life they become too tall and then they say, oh, why I'm too tall? Right? It's always the problem. Never can you be happy in this material. Never. It's always something. Yeah, as soon as we are born, we are pursuing some desire. Every child has a particular desire they want to fulfill. It is there already. It's a matter of time. So your only solution is to give them Krishna so that they will not follow their senses, but they follow the intelligence of Krishna. Of course, if you have good samskars, means you show them good things, they become impressions. The positive impressions, it's called samskars, right? So that will make them become more pious or Krishna conscious. So they have to be exposed to that. Yeah. I will stop for maybe 5 more minutes. Huh?
Dravyo palabdhi sthanasya.
Dravyo palabdhi sthanasya.
Dravyeksha yogyata yada.
Dravyeksha yogyata yada.
Tat panchatvam aham manat. Utpattir dravya darshanam.
Utpattir dravya darshanam.
Yatakshno dravya vayava.
Yatakshno dravya vayava.
Darshana yogyata yada.
Darshana yogyata yada.
Tadaiva chakshusho drashtur.
Tadaiva chakshusho drashtur.
Drashtva yogyatana. Drashtva yogyatana yayoho.
Drashtva yogyatana
yayoho.
Drashtritva yogyatana yayoho.
Translation. When the eyes lose their power to see color or form due to morbid affliction of the optic nerve, the sense of sight becomes deadened. The living entity who is the seer of both the eyes and the sight loses his power of vision. In the same way, when the physical body, the place where perception of objects occurs, is rendered incapable of perceiving, that is known as death. When one begins to view the physical body as one's very self, that is called birth. When everything is good, we think we are great. As everything starts to lose its function, then we can understand we are dying. Prabhupada says in the purport, when one sees, I see, this means that he sees with his eyes or with his spectacles. He sees with the instrument of sight. If the instrument of sight is broken or becomes diseased or incapable of acting, then he, as the seer, also ceases to act. Similarly, in this material body, at the present moment, the living soul is acting And when the material body, due to its incapability to function, ceases, he also ceases to perform his reactionary activities. When one's instrument of action is broken and cannot function, that is called death. So when you get a new instrument, it's called birth. So everything is brand new. At the time of death, you can't use many things. Everything is that you cannot renew anymore. No more, you know, like you go to a auto shop, parts they will fix, and hopefully your car is running, right? But we can't do that. In fact, scientists want to do that, right? They are doing 3D printing of hearts, kidney, and stuff like that. So they are hoping in the future that using your DNA, they can print your heart, new, brand new, cut open, chop here, chop there. But when the whole jiva cannot sustain in the body, he will go. You cannot artificially stop the jiva from leaving. You can try, but you can't hold for long. So everybody wants to live forever in the material body. And the biggest guy was the one who really wanted to live forever was? Hiranyakashipu. He did so much. It's interesting. He wanted to kill Vishnu. So he thought he could ask Brahma to give him a immortal body. But he didn't understand that immortality only comes from Vishnu. And he refused to accept that. And so he's so intelligent, huh? So he figured out a way of asking a boon that would make him almost impossible to be killed. But in any way, the Lord is so good that he is smaller than the atom. He can become smaller, so he found the somehow he got squeezed in. And then he said, your logic don't hold. No animal, no man can kill him. No bhutas, no rakshasas, no snagas, no this, no that. He whatever he claimed, Brahma said, so be it. And I heard later on Narsingadev was telling Brahma, you can't give boons like that.
And then I have to come and save
it. Yeah, you know, situation, you can't. So yeah, so you know.
One.
Somehow it made.
It's not easy. These boons they ask. But then you can see even Ravana had such an amazing quantity of boons, you know. So have to be, I mean, it's true that if you give boons so easily, then these personalities become very unruly and difficult, and it causes so much disturbance to the normal functioning of the universe itself. And Ravana was so proud of his ability that he even went to Yamadutta to fight, to Yamaraj. The Yamaraj got so angry, he came out to kill him. Then Brahma came and said, no, you can't kill him. Because I already gave him the boon. And then he cannot be killed, except, you know. So then he said, do not worry, the Lord will kill him. Like that. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So it is like that. So, even though we are sometimes not able to do, and you will notice as you grow older, some things you cannot do. And I notice like my eyesight's getting weaker and so on. And we can't see, then we have to live with it. You know, we have to live with it. We have to accept it. But you realize this thing is like, even though you know, you can understand you're not this body, but then all these things like there's something covering it.
I remember for our grandfather, he actually lived with us. And he was actually like 95 or 96. He couldn't even go to like school. And
right.
So we had to make a special chair for him. And it had the, what is that they call? The bedpan.
Bedpans.
Yeah. Then my mother used to actually take it out.
So slowly, slowly everything will go and then you have no control. Prabhupada said the final change, your body slowly changes. I remember one sannyasi also, before I didn't say, he was telling that the he got really sick, and then he said his organs weren't functioning, and so they see the doctor. He said, now it's fixed, but it's not 100%. So even though you go and see a doctor, they make you better, but you're never the same. The body is, you know, like one peg down. What do you do?
She wants to go home.
Oh.
She wants to sleep. Coming at it.
Yeah, so Prabhupada says the final change is called death. And if you're not a devotee, then you're forced to take birth in another body. All right, see you. You need to do your duties. So the living entity is Sachit Ananda, just like the Lord. So he has neither birth nor death. Krishna tells Arjuna also. He is actually eternal. Na hanyate hanyamane sharir. Right? He keeps changing body only, but he is not supposed to be the body itself. That's for himself. Therefore, one should not view death with horror, nor have recourse to defining the body as soul. Now give way to exaggeration in enjoying the bodily necessities of life. Realizing the true nature of the living entity, one should move about in the world free from attachment and steadfast in purpose. So we should know what our purpose is. Very important. Huh? Before we came to Krishna consciousness, we didn't know what our purpose was. We thought we have to get some career, some good job, like that. That was
good
our
money.
Purpose. Huh?
Good money.
Good money. That was our purpose. But now we understand what real purpose is. And therefore, to actually function properly in this material world, we have to first be convinced of that purpose. If you are not convinced of the purpose, you'll find that you fall back into your previous conditioning. It happens, even if you are not thinking, it happens because you are not convinced of your spiritual purpose. Half the problem in performing devotional activities is we are not convinced. So here, Kapila Muni is saying, realizing the true nature of the living entity. Once you know theoretically is one thing, but you have to actually practice it, then you realize it. And if you can realize that understanding properly, then it's easy to be not attached to the material world. Anything of this material world, you won't be attached. Then it becomes much easier to perform devotional practices. And that's why prescribed duties help us to come to this stage. You know what to do, father, mother, ashram, whatever, varna you are in. So you do those activities. And you please and you rise above the three modes, like that. Please Krishna and rise above the three modes. So again, Prabhupada says, when one seriously and sincerely engages in the transcendental loving service of the Lord, he is situated in the position of liberation. As long as you are happy doing the service and thinking of Krishna, though at that period, you are liberated. And if someone can do that for a whole life, then they are completely liberated. And Prabhupada says one should try to associate with such people. In the next paragraph, Prabhupada says, actually, renunciation is not possible. If one renounces this palatial building and goes to a forest, there's actually no renunciation. For the palatial building is the property of Supreme Personality of Godhead. So what are you renouncing? Actually, we renounce what?
The idea to enjoy.
Yeah, the idea of attachment to that thing. Yeah. Possessiveness. Who is the proprietor? It's always Krishna. Bhuktaram yadi tapas. He is supposed to enjoy it. If he changes from one property to another, that does not mean that he renounces. He was never the proprietor of either the palace or the forest. So we have to give up the idea of enjoying it. That is real renunciation. Or use it in the service of Krishna. If we try to use it for ourselves, not for the Lord, then it's Falgu Vairagya, false renunciation. Should be used for this enjoyment of Krishna. So therefore, best thing to do is follow what Prabhupada set up for us. Go and do service, temple service, or at home do some service. And then you find that you won't be trying to enjoy things. You will give up that mood of enjoyment. That's what you will eat.
Samyak darshanaya buddhya.
Samyak darshanaya buddhya.
Yoga vairagya yuktaya.
Yoga vairagya yuktaya.
Maya virajite loke.
Maya virajite loke.
Charenyasya kalevaram.
Charenyasya kalevaram.
Endowed with right vision and strengthened by devotional service and a pessimistic attitude towards material identity, one should relegate his body to this illusory world through his reason. Thus one can be unconcerned with this material world. You have to associate with devotees to be able to actually give up the attachment. It's not going to be any other way. Attachment to this world is because we are trying to enjoy it. And if you associate with people who are always enjoying it, then you will also end up wanting to enjoy it. That is a fact. Right? Remember Prabhupada said, if you want to be, they asked him how to be a pure devotee. And then Prabhupada said, how will you become a drunk? Then he said, if you associate a drunk, you become drunker. Similarly, if you associate with devotees, you will end up being a devotee. Again. It's like having a party somewhere. So, seeing perfectly means to understand how to live in this material life in Krishna consciousness. Not try to enjoy it. How to live in such a way that I am not trying to enjoy it. All the time we're trying to enjoy it, right? We keep forgetting. And then after that we realize, man, I'm suffering because I tried to enjoy. When you don't enjoy it, then some people say, then there's no point doing some things. And that is the point. Why are you doing those things? You don't need to do those things. Everything we do, we want some enjoyment. So material things, there are so many things we do unnecessarily because we are looking to enjoy. But when you learn that certain things are not necessary, and then you realize there's no real enjoyment. I think I told you, I had a godbrother who broke off with his family, and then he decided to go and enjoy. That's what he said, I want to go and enjoy. So he did that, and then I think a couple of years later, then I was in a Rathe Yatra and I saw him, and then he came and talked to me, and he said, no, Prabhu, I try to enjoy, I cannot, because every time I try, I see Krishna. He said, I remember all these things that why we don't enjoy. So, but he said, still, you know, I'm still trying. So now he's back, he's doing service and all, because he can't enjoy, once you know. Krishna will not let you go. So the whole idea is to give up that enjoyment. That's what pulls you away from Krishna, because you're always trying to enjoy. So Prabhupada says one's attitude should be in the form of detachment. Okay, I'll use you, but I'm not trying to enjoy you, the material energy. Okay. So then when we use everything in service of Krishna, when you're dying, you don't think this is mine, this is my house, this is my mill, all this you don't think. You think, oh, they are all for Krishna's pleasure. And then you just think of Krishna, okay Krishna. I don't know whether I'm ready or not. If you want to take me back, take me back. Like that. Right? It's up to Krishna. We cannot demand. But we pray, please take me back. Somehow. That's the end of Bhaktivedanta purpose of the third canto, 31st chapter of the Srimad Bhagavatam entitled Lord Kapila's Instructions on the Movements of the Living Entities. We'll stop here. Let's rest my voice.